Welcome at Tech Talk episode 4. Here I will try to answer as many technical questions as possible. If you have questions on your own after watching this clip, leave them at the comment bar and I will try to answer them next week. The first question is coming from Kev from Germany, and he is asking, if I have a 24 volt EasySolar built in my van, can I use the trickle charge for my starter battery? The trickle charge is a takeoff from the main battery, and with that you can parallel charge your starter battery while also your main battery is charged. Well, the output of the trickle charge, voltage-wise, is exactly the same as the unit itself. So if you have a 24 volt EasySolar, also the trickle charge is 24 volt. If you would like to start to charge a starter battery, you would need an Orion, a DC-DC converter, which can convert from 24 volt to 12 volt, and with that, your starter battery can be charged. The next question is coming from Bernie, and Bernie is asking, if I have multiple MPPTs on the same system, on the same battery, should I connect them for improving efficiency, or should I leave them stand alone? Well, Bernie, if you connect them to a servo as such, then the overview will tell the total amount of yield what you have from your charge controllers. Efficiency-wise, not much happens, but they work independent of each other. But as far as the charge regime goes, they know they're connected to the same battery, and they will go together from bulk absorption to float. So it's wise if you have the possibility to interconnect them, but if not, you still have enough efficiency to charge the battery as well. The next question is coming from Freedom from the Philippines, and he is asking, on a servo, there are two relays. How can I use them? Well, the two relays are physically there, but only one is able to be programmed. The servo, as you know, is an open source platform. That means you can write your own code to also control the second relay. But default, with the firmware that we supplied with, only one relay can be used for starting a generator or for, well, any function that you might have. The second relay, at the moment, that's not usable. The next question is coming from Amanda, and Amanda is asking, I have a Multiplus, and on that Multiplus, while on shore power, my float and absorption LEDs are blinking. What is it? Well, most likely, in your case, this is a matter of a temperature sensor, which is either faulty or is wrongly installed, so that the polarity is not correct. If you want to know all the LED codes, we have a special app for that. It's called Victron Tools, and with Victron Tools, you can find that in the App Store. All the LED indications and what they mean can be found there. So if you have a LED code on your unit, you can open the app, try to find the same blinking as on your unit, and then it will tell you exactly what the error code means. The next question is from Ralf. It's a rather long one. Ralf is asking, if I have an inverter installed in my vehicle and my ground relay is active, which means the neutral and the ground is connected in inverter mode, what happens then if I step out of the car using some electrical device? Because then I have a perhaps a conflict in earth. Well, if you have your ground relay active, that means that in your car, your RCD will work as intended because you're on the same polarity. If you step out the car, you have a different ground. That means your RCD will not work. That isn't necessarily dangerous because most appliances that you have are doubly isolated. That means there's hardly any risk that you can touch any electricity whatsoever. Theoretically, you should ground also your vehicle to the ground outside, or you can use something else. It's an isolation watch, which tests if the isolation is still in order. And if something would go wrong on a device which we use outside the vehicle, also the breaker will trip. In general, if you use double isolated loads, then there is not an issue at all, and you can just leave it as it is. The last question is coming from Stefan, and Stefan is asking, how is it possible that my voltage on my battery is below 12 volt, but my state of charge on my BMW is above 80%? Well, Stefan, I got a lot of these questions, and to answer that, I need to explain completely how the algorithm works on the state of charge calculation. And that's a little bit too long for Tech Talk, but there will be shortly after this, there will be an explanation on how synchronization works. So either for the BMW, but also on the multis. And hopefully you will find that interesting enough and will explain enough for you to understand how that's done. Thank you for watching this episode. Again, if you have technical questions on your own, you can leave them in the comment bar and I will try to answer them next time. You can also go online to the Victron community because maybe it's even faster to have the answers found over there. For now, bye-bye.